information from. But you know, there were other women around and there were some kids, and I realized I really wanted to stand up for myself and, you know, maybe inspire people to stand up for themselves. So I shouted back at this person. I said, "I'm not here for your sexual enjoyment." Yeah, I mean, off the cuff, you know, it's the best I could come up with. But I have to say, this is the imperfect response when someone says, "Hey, lady, you gotta stop at the light." Stripe. Right? Their advertising is terrible. I feel like I have an idea though for their ad agency. It is a Plaid Pantry mobile app, and it's just a live video feed of whichever one's being robbed. I mean, it makes sense, you know? Their slogan is get in, get it, and get going. They're not even asking you to pay, so. Is you know that magazine they sell there with all the mugshots in it? It's called Busted. I feel like you can really roll that into a customer appreciation flyer. I didn't know that men had pubes. Like for way too long, I figured it out. It was just really late. Like I didn't know, you know, in sex ed they don't ever show pubes on men. In all the drawings, you're like, men have a penis and women have like a privacy cube triangle. So my first time like reaching down there, I was surprised. And my first thought was like, not that my information was wrong, it was that he was a woman. Found out he wasn't a woman. But I did make him turn on the lights and like show me what I was working with. I was like, oh my god, all this time I thought the happy trail just stopped at the waistband. So it was a relief to me. And it was not so much for him. Seeing as now I'm like inspecting him like he's a horse I'm buying. And clearly I have never ridden a horse. Pubeless, and women, we were personally responsible for all bad things pube related. You know, like every stray pube or merkin. What I'm saying is, not only is it important to have sex ed in our schools, it needs to be more graphic for the children. I had a rough childhood. I was raised autistic. Napoleon Dynamite, it was like watching a family home video. Like, my parents gave me just terrible comebacks to tell bullies. So, like, curly hair and glasses, I'd say things like, "Don't call me Weird Al. You're just jealous because I saw him at the state fair." Show of hands, how many people want to put my bike in a tree right now? Weird Al, now you know I'm a fan. My maiden name was Johnson, so some really clever person decided to call me Toiletson. And it, like, Toilet John, it's really complicated. We can talk about it after the show if you'd like. Luckily, though, I had this gem of a comeback from my mom just at the ready. Do you guys want to hear it? All right, can you guys just shout out, "Hey, Toiletson"?
Hey.
Actually, it's Johnson, son of John, and my great-grandpa, his name was John. When he was a kid, they didn't even have toilets. They had chamber pots. So I was Molly Chamberpot. Many of you guys have cats? Cat people? They let you out tonight. That's great. I stayed at a friend's house the other night, and they had two cats, and they slept on my bed. And in the middle of the night, I woke up to the sound of them cleaning each other. And if you don't know what that sounds like, it's kind of like this. I hope no one's eating. The thing, though, I had to make that noise because I want to let you know that in the middle of the night, I woke up and I thought that was a sound of these cats having sex with each other? Obviously, that's not what these cats were doing, because if this is what these cats were doing, it'd be the most intimate cat sex ever. Just like eyes locked in missionary position, just love and intention and respect. Are you guys picturing this? Because it's also pretty cute. The thing though is, this ruined my own cat sleeping on my bed for me, because now I just imagine, when I hear that noise, I just imagine he's masturbating. One last thing, kind of serious. You guys all know, if you're pregnant, do not drink alcohol. It makes the baby's head bigger. But if your baby already has Zika, which gives your baby a tummy head,